I'm not talking about going back to Gaza as a colonialist, as we did in 1967. No. I'm talking about going back to Gaza as the owner of the land, as we did in Yafo in 1948.
Without any further ado, I would like to ask you please to give a respectful welcome, not very joyful for what's going on, but a respectful welcome to the Deputy Speaker of the House, Haver Knesset Moshe Feiglin.
Thank you, Aryeh. Thank you all. And right now there is a hard battle going on over there in Sajaiya. And we really have to ask ourselves, where is it going? Israel left Gaza, the city of Gaza, many years before the disengagement. We always mix up between the two. At the Gerush from Gush Katif in 2005, we just expel ourselves and destroy the Jewish villages. We were not in Gaza then. Redrawing from Gaza, we did because of the Oslo process. My solution is to, first of all, and before everything else, to realize and to understand and to remember that the city of Gaza, there's no difference between the city of Gaza and the city of Yafo. Two Israeli, Eretz Israeli cities sitting on the seashore of the Mediterranean. What's the difference between Gaza and Yafo? 19 years, that's the whole difference. The Arabs in Yafo are exactly the same Arabs as in Gaza. Came to Israel approximately the same time, from the same places, by the way, most of them from Egypt. Same thing, exactly the same thing. The history of Yafo, both biblical cities, by the way, with long Jewish history. There was a Jewish community in Gaza until 1936. Very famous shul. Rabbi Shalom Najara, that we sing his Shabbos songs every week, was the chief rabbi of Gaza. But the commentator asked me, is Gaza part of Eretz Israel? And I'm talking about serious people, intelligent people. He did not become a commentator in Channel 2 because of nothing. Is it really part of Eretz Israel? Yes, in the last 20 years, we brainwashed ourselves to death. We're not defending ourselves. We're fighting for justice. It's ours. This is the first thing we should understand. And we should take it over. And we should take it over, capture the whole Gaza Strip, as we did in 1967. And I'm talking about the right goal. The right goal should be victory. Nothing less than that. Victory means destroying your enemy and take over the place. The enemy is not the tunnels. The enemy is not the rockets. And the target is definitely not to weaken the Hamas. Did Churchill said that the enemy is the Luftwaffe's airplanes? Was the target to weaken Hitler, yimach shmo? If that's the way World War II would have been done, there would be no victory at the end of it. God forbid. The 6 days war, it took less than a day to take over the Gaza Strip. It took 6 days to win the whole war. It took about a day to take over the Gaza Strip. You don't run after tunnels, you don't go into the homes. You hit the leadership hard. You understand that you're the good guy and they're the bad guy. You represent good. They represent evil. We have a war over here. And the war is not against the Hamas. And there's no innocent people around it. So these are the two rules. First of all, we should look for victory. We should win. We should take over. We should destroy Hamas and take over the take over the whole city, and we should do it according to Jewish moral, and not according to this immoral ideas that putting our soldiers in danger. Now the question is, what are we going to do afterwards? The question is, what are we going to do afterwards with 1.8 million Arabs in Gaza? Well, there are three categories. The first category is those who fighting against you, who fought against you, fighting against you, still not accepting your full sovereignty on your land. And if I did not mention that, of course it's part of it. I'm not talking about going back to Gaza as a colonialist, as we did in 1967. No. I'm talking about going back to Gaza as the owner of the land, as we did in Yafo in 1948. Those who fought you in the past or don't accept your sovereignty today should be destroyed or sent away. That's the first category. It's simple. 80%, around 80%, maybe more, of the people who live in Gaza Strip wants to leave, wants to find a future in a better place, out of this country. I'm talking about it for many years. 2 weeks ago, another big survey was published in Ynet website that shows that 80% of them wish to leave. Israel can help that process to happen. Israel should invest a lot of money that today is being invested in rockets, in barbed wires, in guards in every coffee shop, and so on, exactly in that target. So in 10, 15 years, the population will be much, the Arab population in Gaza will be much smaller. And the minority that will decide to stay can stay somehow with the same, as with the same position as the Arab in East Jerusalem did. Not immediately, not automatically. They'll have to go through a few tests and so on. A few years should pass, and only according to the Israeli interest and on our own time and on our own amount that we will decide to let them get that position, they will be able to. Meanwhile, we should look at reality and see that a tremendous miracle is going on today in the land of Israel. All the population in the world, east and west, including the Arab world, is shrinking, getting smaller and smaller. People not having more than two kids today. Most of the countries, east and west, having less, including the Arab world. The only community, if I can call it, that is growing today in the whole world, instead of getting smaller, is the Jewish community in Eretz Israel, not in the diaspora, in Eretz Israel. By the way, every year in Judea and Samaria, 15,000 Arabs leaves anyhow, without any help. I believe that in the coming decade, we're going to see a million, maybe a million and a half Jews coming to Eretz Israel. And that will change all the way of thinking today. There's nowhere to put them besides, in these major numbers, besides Judea and Samaria, by the way. Israel is too small. Thus, Israel is becoming not just the state of the Jews, but the state of all the Jews. to going further to the next level, which Hashem is taking us. We need Jewish leadership, manhigut, yireat shamayim, and this is what we aiming to. As Arya said, in the last 15 years, we marked it as our goal, and we continue going on that path, and we're having great achievements. Be'ezrat Hashem, there will be primaries in Likud sooner or later, and you can vote at the primaries to the leader of the Likud, and most chances, the leader of the state of Israel. We are not far away from there. We'll get there, Be'ezrat Hashem. Be'ezrat Hashem, and Be'ezrat each one of you.